already have some
few words. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I'm gonna make it more personal.
So
it's fine. I think that's not important, but I was just wondering, so that we are a bit coordinated.
Yeah.
So the three of them are called the points.
Okay.
So hi. So the board that will hand the award, both of them will give the award to each other,
okay.
And then the stand on the call to present.
Perfect. Thank you.
Please. Hello, hello, welcome back.
Hi, Abdus Salam. You're very welcome.
Is that maybe?
Okay, so welcome everybody. Good afternoon. It's a great pleasure to see all the young faces here coming from so many different countries. So welcome. This is perhaps your first, major event at ICTP that you're attending. I'm also very happy that this is, after 2 years, you know, it's nice that we are able to really see each other in person, unlike the last 2 years. You can also live a more normal life, you know, take a stroll by the seaside, which was not the case last 2 years, so welcome. And it's, I think, a nice introduction for you to be present to this Spirit of Abdus Salam Award ceremony, to really get a feeling for the spirit of the center. I'm pleased to have Muhammad Salam here, the son of our founding director, Abdus Salam. Who will formally introduce the 2022 award winners and the winners themselves. So we have three of them here. Let me very quickly introduce them. I think Ahmad will say more about them. So sincere welcome to Professor Malik Maaza, whose career has been intertwined with that of ICTP for decades. You know, given the convergence of his own vision for fostering research and ending isolation of scientists in Africa, which is the same mission as ICTP, especially through the creation of Nano AFNET, which is the Pan-African voice in the area of nanoscience and nanotechnology, which is recognized worldwide. And now, as I was discussing with him yesterday, the next step is going to be ACCENT, and ICTP is looking forward to a collaboration on that front. Then next person awardee is Madame Conchita Mosca, whose history with ICTP also spans almost the entire life of the center itself. And the diploma program's numbers, you know, last year we celebrated and some 1,000 students had graduated in the last 30 years. I mean, they speak for themselves. But it was Conchita who, through the early days in 1991 until her retirement in 2002, she provided the support, you know, both actual secretarial support but also moral support to the students to endure this 1 year of very intense study and cultural change. And you will understand what I mean. It's, sometimes it can be difficult, especially in the beginning months. So, and finally, warm welcome to Professor Adnan Shihab Eldin, whose relationship with ICTP also dates back to 1976, after he met Abdus Salam in Kuwait. And at that time, he was the vice president of Kuwait University and director general of Kuwait Institute for Scientific Research, which is one of the most important research centers in the Gulf world. Since then, he has been very supportive of ICTP activities. Even when he left Kuwait for positions in UNESCO, IAEA, and OPEC in Vienna, very steadfast support when he was the director general of KFAS. And I really cannot think of better ambassadors for the mission of ICTP than these people who are here in very different parts of the world in very different roles. And so it's a very pleasure for me to, you know, to welcome you to this wonderful ceremony. And it's actually a special occasion because I want to now sincerely thank Adnan for being the first one. This was one of the little surprises I had promised to the staff meeting. He's going to be the first one, and I think it's very appropriate that he's the first one to contribute to the International Science Endowment Fund that I mentioned before to the staff, which is our effort to increase our resources. And his contribution will allow ICTP to apply for grants primarily for the support of students. So. Thank you, Arnaud. So it's for all of you here, for the students. And the creation of such a fund together with this contribution, this is our really, we have been last two years, we have been really working hard on this. This is the cornerstone of our new effort to raise funds from more broadly than, you know, than our institutional donors so far. And I really want to personally thank Adnan for his support. On another note, I'm also very pleased. I mean, today we will have another little surprise for the diploma students, which I will come to later, which is once again related to the diploma program. For now, I will congratulate the three winners. And I give the floor to Ahmed.
Should I go up?
Oh, you can go there, yeah.
In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the ever merciful. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it is a great pleasure to be with you again after the gap imposed by COVID. And it's always very emotional for me to stand here because this is where my father stood all those years ago. And I have been visiting here now, as I said to my son, Qasim, who's with me on this trip. I first visited ICTP 57 years ago, which puts a pretty interesting age on me. I was a very little boy then, but it's 57 years I've been coming here, and that probably puts me almost unique in the category of visitors to ICTP. And I have many, many memories of being here, many memories of being with my father, and those very first days in the Piazza Obadan, the old building in the center of Trieste, sitting in his office with him, playing on the blackboard while he did his work, and I used to rub out his work and did my drawings on the blackboard, which he was not very pleased with, but he forgave me then. So it's an honor to represent the whole family, my sisters who cannot be here, and my brother as well, and to represent the whole Salam family. And it's a very important time for us because it's a generational commitment that we have to ICTP. I won't take up too much of your time with some of the war stories of ICTP, but the thing that I wanted to talk about was essentially the essence of ICTP. And the center was not created, nor did it come about because of a scientific need. It came about because of a humanitarian need, and that need was recognized by my father. As many of you know, Abdus Salam in Arabic means a servant of peace. And that name was not a name just given to him in an ordinary fashion. Again, as some of you will see in the film, you'll know I've told the story that his father, before he was born, my grandfather, before my father was born, had a dream. And in that dream, he was given a son. And he was told in that dream to call the son Abdus Salam. So we believe that God gave him his name, and that's a very important sign. And as you know, my father lived up to that name, and for us, ICTP remains his greatest legacy. This legacy came about from an extreme, and as Nigel Calder, when he stood here in 1997 and gave a talk about my father, he talked about his cosmic anger. And that anger was an anger and a passion to address the inequality between the developing world and the developed world, and the arrogance of the developing world believing that they could repress the developed world. And people like you, just by accident of their birth, who were deprived of opportunities in their own countries. And that was his driving passion. He, my father himself, was deeply affected by the predicament of whether to leave his family back in 1952, 1953, or leave his country, or leave physics. And it was with a very heavy heart that he chose to leave his family and leave his country. And if you can remember, some of you will be aware of the fact that in those days, the only form of communication was good old snail mail. You wrote a letter, and it took 3 weeks to get to the person, and you waited 3 weeks for the reply to come. Nobody had telephones in those days in Pakistan. There was no question of direct dialing. If somebody, I remember when my father used to book a call, he'd phone the operator, book a call, and my grandfather didn't have a telephone. He didn't have the money to have a telephone. So the message would go to the neighbor who had the telephone to say, we're going to phone tomorrow. Can you please come and make sure that my grandfather comes and sits in your house and waits all day for that phone to ring? And that was how they used to communicate. So you can imagine the impact that had on my father, not having any communication with his family at all for weeks on end. And that was a huge wrench for him. And in his mind, he vowed that no one else should ever have to face that decision. And he also knew that for any country to grow economically and be independent economically, it needed to have access to science and technology. And it needed access to science and technology in its own home territory, where people could benefit from the education that they received and take it back to their own countries and give that education further to the citizens of their own countries. And that essentially was the essence of ICTP, for people not to be part of the brain drain leaving their countries for the developed countries where the opportunities were much brighter and much greater. That's, as I said, was how ICTP was born. And father fought incredible prejudice and ignorance at the highest levels in order to make this dream a reality. And I saw firsthand how hard he worked, how hard he fought, and how he overcame the doubters by his intellect and his charm. He beat the objectors to setting up ICTP. And here we are all these years later, and there's you, the younger generation, about to take over. And his dreams have come true, and it's wonderful to see the results of all his hard work. And it wasn't just at the beginning that he fought so hard. Throughout his life, he had to work hard to keep the lights on, literally keep the lights on. And at this stage, I must pay full tribute to UNESCO, the IAEA for their support, but above all else, for the generosity of the Italian government, who, as Atish will know, have gone out of their way over many years to support ICTP and have taken a great pride in ICTP, and we owe them a huge debt of gratitude. Now, while Father was working so hard to keep the center's lights on, literally, he was also doing his own work, and he was running the center. And typically, he would say his day was divided into three parts, one for his visitors and students, one third for his science, and one third to run the center. That would have broken many a lesser man, but somehow he made it happen, and he gave all the visitors and the students his time, his support, and his commitment. And yet, through all this, he never forgot his humble roots and never forgot to make time for everybody who needed it. And he sacrificed himself, his life, his family, and ultimately his health for the sake of his students and the ICTP. And it is this that we, the Salam family, remember as the spirit of Salam. And it is this spirit that we wish to keep alive, the spirit of selflessness, of sacrifice, of commitment, and a genuine love for humanity. The Spirit of Salam Award is an award given by the family to a person who has worked tirelessly and without limits in the spirit of Abdus Salam, well beyond their job specification. Someone who's gone beyond their defined role and gone out of their way to guide, help, mentor, or just be there for members of ICTP family. And we passionately believe it is critical and essential to keep the spirit of Salam alive and to remind everyone that this is the essence of ICTP and it was a quality of Abdus Salam. It's what differentiated ICTP then, it differentiates it now, and it's what makes it unique even in this day and age. I'm absolutely delighted that we have such incredible recipients today and honored to have them with us today. I just wanted to say the award is open to all, and we want to recognize the scientific staff, the administrative staff, the maintenance staff. Every single person is eligible for this award, because that's the way my father treated everybody. He didn't have any hierarchy between people. Everybody was just as important to him. And if anyone has touched your lives and helped you, please nominate them. Put their names down and nominate them for award for next year. We really want to make this as inclusive as an award and a recognition as possible. I'll end with a few thoughts from one of Father's collaborators, a student and a deep friend of his, Professor Riazuddin, who wrote in his recently published autobiography. He suggested Salam's work and life is summarized in two words, curiosity and compassion. Victor Weisskopf said, compassion without curiosity is ineffective, and curiosity without compassion is inhuman. Curiosity led Salam to seek unity in the various phenomena of nature, but it was his compassion which led him to seek unity in mankind and to work for the benefit of mankind. And this was the crowning achievement of his work, and the creation of the ICTP and its development is testament to Abdus Salam. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for your time. I now go on to the great pleasure of introducing Abdus Salam's personal vision and his relationship. And if I start with Malik, who, as Atisha just said, he has gone well beyond his own work specification, to put it in a very crude sense. He has gone out of his way to go beyond the sense of duty and work with the ICTP Office of External Activities and played a crucial role in helping science, not only in Africa, but also in other Islamic countries and in Pakistan as well, which is always very close to my father's heart. We're deeply in gratitude to Malik, and we absolutely recognize and honor the work that he's done in father's memory. Perhaps Concetta has done more in her own way by being as a mentor and a support, which is what father spent so much time doing. And maybe, Concetta, you subconsciously picked up the vibes from my father, and that gave you the ability to support the young students and help them, which is a critical part of what they do. As Satish said, it's a very intense course, and the fact that you've been able to hold their hands, guide them through it has been wonderful. And thank you so much from all of us. And Adnan is the exception because, of course, he's not a member of ICTP staff, but his incredible commitment to my father and a man who stood up in the face of a great deal of opposition and constantly supported and worked for my father made us feel that he had to be recognized, and we owe him a huge debt of gratitude, and even more so now with the teacher's recent announcement. So thank you from the bottom of our hearts to all three of you for your help and support. Thank you very much. So now I believe, so Professor Nunn, if you'd like to step up and Oh, sorry. My apologies. We're starting with you first. My apologies.
Program Director, Professor Dabholkar, Professor Salam, dear junior and senior colleagues, first of all, I wish to express my gratitude to the ICTP family and to my two senior colleagues here present with us. I'm really thrilled to be in this kingdom here of the ICTP. For us in Africa, it is the Mecca of science. It is the Vatican of science. It is Jerusalem of science. Whenever we come here to ICTP and we go back, we are fully under full adrenaline. And we know that we have enough resources to be able to come with the sound impact so far in Africa. So I wish to share with you some slides, colleagues, junior and senior, just to show you how the compass of Ustad Abdus Salam was used by us from Africa and in the South in general to trigger more or less and pursue on his footsteps. Next, please. I wish to single out some of the initiatives that I was involved in either initiating or implementing with a number of colleagues from the family of the ICTP here, the Condors and Meta, the International Relations Office, and others. I would like to single one. The first one is the LAM network that Professor Ahmed Wage and Professor Paul Bouabassoua from Ghana and Senegal, respectively, have initiated and implemented. And that was in the early times of late Galeno de Nardomei, his soul stays in peace, que son âme repose en paix. The other one, the LAM network, was created during the era of Ustad Abdus Salam himself. And after that, it has created a huge boost of lasers and optics, photonics in the African continent. And then after the African Union in that time, NEPAD, has came with the a possibility to widen this LAM network and to give it more resources and so on, and therefore there was a creation of the African Laser Center, which is based indeed in South Africa, supported by the South African government and the African Union at a certain extent, but driven by African fellows who have been trained mainly from the ICTP photonics and optics labs here. The other one that I would like just to mention, the idea was more or less took place somehow from the condensed matter division, and that is the African Material Research Society, which was created in Pretoria, but supported by the NSF in the US, that was in the 1999. Then in 2005, I was a student in early career here, and I was coming, and that the ICTP has opened its doors for us. And I came here and let Galino DiNardo, may his soul stays in peace. He assisted us as well as with the photonic community, that is Johnny Amela and the International Office, and the condensed matter, of course, have allowed us to initiate here and to launch in 2005 in Adriatico the Nanoscience African Network, which became extremely very dynamic, and we were emulating and copying the model of the ICTP somehow, or more or less the diploma program that my left angel has initiated with the late Abdus Salam. And in 2006, of course, again, the ICTP was the source of initiating the African Physical Society, the IFPS, that was in Dakar in 2006. And again, with the condensed matter and Ralph Khebawa and Johnny Emela and other colleagues, we came with the initiating the African Network for Solar Energy. That was more or less, the idea was born here in ICTP, of course, and it was launched in Linz in Austria. And in 2013, in that time, I must admit we have had the support, a very robust support letter and moral commitment from the ICTP, and the UNESCO requested us to apply and to be awarded the sole UNESCO nano in the South, and that was created in 2013. And of course, the ANDI, among others, I'm just singling out some. There is ASESMA, there is quite a large cohort of initiatives in Africa and running extremely very well, very smoothly and effectively. Next, please. And this culminated, of course, colleagues, by the creation of the ICTP Africa, in East Africa, the AFR, which is the moon of the ICTP in Africa, as the one in Brazil. We do understand that, the sun and the moon, both of them do shine, but one is the source of light, the other one does reflect it. We do understand our mother institution is the ICTP, and in Trieste, and ICTPs in East of Africa, in Rwanda, for which the patron is the Honorable President Kagame, as a patron and as a moral guarantee, showing that, in effect, policymakers now in the African continent are convinced about the science and the technology. I would like just to mention that, and if you allow me to do so, the first revelation to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was "Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq," read on the name of his Almighty, and that was read. The commandment, where the table of commandment was written, therefore Moses has to read also, and so on and so on. So it's extremely important. The education is the cornerstone of any belief, and so on, and therefore we continue in that regard. Next, please. I wish to share with you some hard facts, as we say, as St. Thomas, comme St. Thomas, on a crocus qu'on voit. As St. Thomas, we believe only what we see. Here we have duplicated at a nanoscale, of course, at our level, and not at the level of the mother institution, ICTP, but we have duplicated, have somehow, and emulated what Honorable Madame Mosca has initiated with the Ustad Salam, created something equivalent at the postgrad level, and we have fellows from Burkina Faso, Uganda, Cameroon, South Africa, and so on and so on, a number of African countries. But we have not, neglected those who are in a difficult situation, those who are in a war zones, Yemen and Ethiopia and other parts of the world, and in particular here in Libya, for example, the gentleman and his wife. Next, please. As again, the NanoAfNet has allowed us more or less to embark in this program that Honorable Mosca has more or less initiated with Abdus Salam, late Abdus Salam, here. So we, within the UNESCO chair, we increased the more or less the number, and in particular the gender aspect. I was just telling some of the colleagues is that the first believer in Islam was Khadija radiallahu anha, the wife of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam Muhammad. I do firmly believe that likely the Islam would not have such a dimension all over the world if the first believer was not a lady. And I also go that route and say that there would be no Christianity if there were no Mary the Virgin. Maryam al-Adra, if there was no Maryam al-Adra, there would be no Isa alayhi salam, no Christianity. So the role of women in this society. And therefore, we embark in gender equity. Next, please. And that is really a must for us. It's a must for us. Humanity, for since historical dates, have neglected the half of humanity. We cannot do that. We have to embark in, boosting the education and bringing our sisters and our mothers within the same path as we have had the chance to do. Next, please. Next, please. So we embarked in the co-diploma. And as you can see, fellows from Francophone countries, they do indeed embark with us, and they end by getting an Anglophone diploma. So some of them, they get two double diplomas because they go back home where, have amassed somehow a large amount of databases and results. They go back to their home place where they can also work on other subjects and so on. Next, please. Next, please. Just a typical example, dear senior and junior colleagues, just to give you an idea. When you publish, you are cited. If the research work that you are doing is of an interest, so colleagues from China, from Russia, from wherever they are, they will cite your work. That means they have read it and they have been interested by it. And as you can see, colleagues, before we were at some 10, 20 per year citations. Once we embarked in 2005 with the Nano AFNET and the chair, for which the ICTP was emulated somehow or copied, somehow duplicated at a small level, as you can see, the publication there was a rise, an exponential type rise of that. And we always look how much we are doing. In 2022, we are at around 3,700. Thank you. Next, please. Again, colleagues, I will just give back to Caesar, which belongs to Caesar, and to Cleopatra, which belongs to Cleopatra, is that, yes, indeed, we are extremely indebted to the Italian nation, to the UNESCO, and to the spirit of Abdus Salam, late Abdus Salam. And in that regard, the Trieste system has played a major role in that regard, in particular the ICTP, Abdus Salam ICTP Center. And colleagues, I would like just to share with you this. Today we have, we inherit in different ways. We have two generations of late Abdus Salam. We are very well aware that the DNA is inherited 50% from our mothers and 50% of our fathers. We have the living DNA of late Abdus Salam with us today. There is another inheritance type approach that is the spirit. And that spirit of Abdus Salam is with us. It's not the real DNA, but it is. And it's entangled with the natural DNA. And may his spirit stays forever. In effect, we, from the African perspective, again, Abdus Salam legacy and Abdus Salam Center and his vision is somehow the equivalent of the North Star or the Southern Cross stars that we use as a compass to guide ourselves, and we will ensure that his legacy will stay forever. Shukran jazilan.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Now we call on Conchetta, please.
As you can see, I'm very nervous. I'm not used to speaking in front of large audiences. But I'm honored to accept the Spirit of Salam Award and thank the Salam family, the director of the center, and the awards committee for bestowing it upon me. I also thank whoever put my name forth, because I still feel all I did was my job as best I could. I greatly admired Professor Salam and always remember the sense of mission he instilled in all of us who were fortunate enough to have worked under him. Working at the center was one of the most rewarding experiences of my life, especially when I was secretary of the diploma program and met such deserving young people. Many scientists thought the program wouldn't work, but I remembered that Professor Salam had had an ICTP degree program in his heart already in the 1970s. And I was confident that if all of us, Professors Yulu and Ranj Bardayami, who were the acting heads of the program, the coordinators, the lecturers, and the ICTP staff, did our best to make it work, it would. I thank everybody for their collaboration because it was the combined effort and commitment that made the program become one of the most successful here at the center. Without everyone's input, it would never have been this good. I loved working for the students, getting to know them on a personal basis throughout their good and bad times. I know how difficult it is to live in a foreign country, not knowing its climate, nor its language and customs, studying under lecturers who had new ways of teaching, and such a diverse group of students as classmates. In fact, during their time in the program, some told me that they had never slept even one night away from their own home. Others had never seen snow, or had never seen women dressed in a certain type of attire. Some had never met a person of a different culture or creed from their own. Thus began the shared lunch hours and after-work coffee meetings with the students, outings or parties to mark special occasions, including whenever the coordinators and lecturers so they would be together in a more informal basis. The students brought a youthfulness to the center, and despite some difficulties, they all made it through. I'm sure that you new students will also succeed in doing so. I enjoyed every minute of the diploma program, sharing the students' joys and woes, their fears and satisfactions, learning from, as well as helping them. They became the other children I didn't have, because I have only one. And with many of the students, warm, friendly, and lasting relationships were formed. I remember each of the past students for some personal characteristic they had, or for some particular event that happened during their stay. From time to time, I'm still in touch with a good number of them, and have met, so to speak, their new families, wives, husbands, and children, as they form. Many have won prestigious awards, honors, and grants. Many have their own laboratory or research group. Still others are now in important positions. All tell me they are doing their best to help young students advance, whether in their home country or from their adopted country, much like Professor Salam himself did. So thanks go to them as well for the success of this program. I close by sending them all my most affectionate regards, wishing all of you, including Patricia and Sandra, who worked so hard to look after the students, the best in the future, and again thanking those who were so kind as to grant me the award. The honor and recognition are appreciated and will be cherished.
That was wonderful.
Thank you so much. And last, but by no means least, Professor Adnan, it's been a great pleasure.
Good evening, and thank you very much, Dr. Ahmed. Thank you very much, Dr. Atish, for your kind words. And distinguished guests, members of the faculty, students, fellows, all of you, I extend to you my sincerest greetings tonight in accepting this award that is very dear to my heart. I want to thank the family of Dr. Salam for bestowing on me this honor with my co-recipient, and Atish for his really doing such a great job. Thank you all. It is a privilege for me to be among select awardees, not only this year, but all of those years, because the award recognizes the dedication Abdus Salam had for a humanitarian passion, vision for the development and advancement of science and technology and innovation in the developing countries. And that, to me, is very dear. That's what I have devoted my career. And there is a reason why I devoted my career, because I was one of the many lucky scientists that were touched by Dr. Salam in person, as we say, not virtually. And I have been influenced by his guidance and inspired by his vision and dedication. You know, my first encounter with Professor Salam was in the 70s. Before I came to ICTP, in Kuwait, he used to come to Kuwait, especially after 73, to advocate, to urge the region to use its wealth to build centers of excellence, to restore Ummat al-Ilm fil Islam. That's the words that he used. And we maintained our relationship. We interacted through not just the 70s, but the 80s and the 90s until God rested him from the endeavors that he committed himself to do. And you know, Professor Salam recognized something very important that I believe in, and he taught me that. That science development flourishes with diversity and openness. Open system, diverse system survive. I was recently in a conference in Italy, in Lake Como, when a guy from Toyota on electric vehicle cells chose to talk about biodiversity is the reason we are all here, because that maintained resilience in the evolution of human being against extinction. The dinosaurs, 70% of living things disappeared with that big extinction, but because there was diversity, immense diversity, survived and we are better. And I think the same thing applies throughout. He considered science to be the ultimate endeavor of the human mind and the spirit, and he stressed its fundamental role in the advancement of the societies and civilization. So basic science is really an important thing for the mind and the spirit, and it drives development, drives technology. And that's very important. And he basically was very passionate, dedicated to the revival of scientific leadership in the Muslim country and in the developing world at large. And he stressed often that what we need is to promote the development of science culture in the society, science culture. During his multiple visits in the 70s and later on, Professor Salam devoted special attention to advocate for the establishment of science centers, centers of excellence. He talked to the leaderships of these countries directly, the emirs, the prime ministers, the minister of education in Kuwait, in the Gulf states. When he was speaking in meetings, in conferences, he never get tired. Even though he may have spoken 100 times and no result, he continued until some result happened. I have no doubt that because of what his urging and advocacy, many of the current centers of excellence in the Gulf, in the Middle East, are to some extent, they owe to his advocacy, including, for example, the Kuwait Foundation for the Advancement of Science, which was established soon after he visited Kuwait first 2 years. And it's a unique thing. It's a combination between private and public, funded by the private sector, but patronized by the Emir of Kuwait as being the chairman of the board. And it was established in 1976 after a few of his visits. So the foundation, of course, as I said, it's a very unique in that sense. I do recall, of course, my first visit to the center in 1976. And I was here in August 1976. I was vice rector of Kuwait University, as was mentioned earlier. But I was accompanying the president of the university, Dr. Hassan Ibrahim, to sign an agreement to formalize the cooperation that was already taking place between Kuwait University and the center, which allowed young scientists from all over the world working at Kuwait University to come and spend few weeks, few months at the center. So we formalized that in an agreement for 5 years, and then later on it was taken up by CAFAS in 1981. Dr. Adnan Laqil came here and signed it with Professor Salam, and since then that agreement continued to be renewed later on by other colleagues, and I was very privileged myself to have the opportunity to continue to provide that support of CAFAS, and I'm confident that this will be maintained because it's in the interest of Kuwait, and it's the interest of the region, and Kuwait will not survive if the region does not survive, and it's the interest of the region because the region will not survive if the world does not survive. So I am confident that this partnership will continue in one way or another because it had expanded in scope that allowed Salam's lectureship, postdocs, fellowships, diploma students, and so on. And I really was very privileged to have played a part in it, small part. I think my predecessor, Dr. Adnan, Dr. Ali Shamplan, played a bigger part in making it happen at that time. My job was easier, is to maintain it and strengthen it. So I'm sure that others who will come after us will also provide that kind of support because it's the interest, as I said, of Kuwait. And the leadership of Kuwait has thrived itself, proud throughout its history, before oil, on helping others. And we continued that tradition after oil. We're proud to help in a small way, in a big way, wherever it happens. That's the tradition of the Kuwait society. In 1981, I was privileged to interview myself, Professor Salam, during a visit he had, soon after CAFAS signed an agreement with the ICTP, in Kuwait TV in English. And rather than talk about it, if you allow me, I will show two video clips from that. If I could have the first clip, Walter.
Professor Salam, would you tell us
this is not me.
A little bit about your work in physics, for which you have been awarded the most distinguished scientific prize in the world?
First, I would like to say that I'm very honored to be in Kuwait. I think Kuwait, with its traditions of stability, freedom, democracy, is really an ideal type of city-state which could rival Athens in the past so far as Arab and Islamic countries are concerned. And it's a great pleasure, of course, for me to be in a brother Muslim country.
The next clip, toward the end, I think the message spoken powerfully but politely.
Dedication, softly. To science.
What happened? Can we play it again?
Who will follow you? Who will follow you? Perseverance, dedication to science. to pure science and to applied science, because I think they go hand in hand. I think not only you're a great scientist, but you're a great human being, and we would like to thank you for this opportunity of being with us here in Kuwait. And we wish that we would have an opportunity and occasion to see you in the future. If you have anything else that you would like to tell us, please do so.
Well, I can once again iterate what I said before, that Kuwait has a very great future, and I hope that it becomes the center of that Ummatul Ilm fil Islam, which we have talked about. So, Salaamu Alaikum to you and to your listeners.
Alaikum Assalam. Thank you very much. Thank you.
I would ask Walter to show quickly a few pictures that depict the relationship between KFS, Kuwait, and Dr. Salam and the center. The first one is the signing of the agreement. Let's go back. That's the signing of the agreement, 1981, between KFS, this Director General, Professor Salam. The next one is in a TWAS conference right after the invasion and the liberation of Kuwait, 1992, I believe, first major international conference that the Sheikh Jaber, the Emir of Kuwait, with Abdus Salam sitting right next to him. And it shows that Abdus Salam went to Kuwait right after the liberation of Kuwait, and he went, and Kuwait embraced the Third World Academy of Science meeting in Kuwait. The first thing we did after liberation of Kuwait is to embrace the international scientific community in the Third World as a sort of say thank you, but also to say welcome to Kuwait. We would like to continue our collaboration. These are, you know, powerful words that he uttered. And when I listened to his explanation in the rest of the video, which I cannot show you, it's long. In simple terms, an exciting new frontiers of physics is being explained. That was Abdus Salam. He could do the science in a simple way, but he could be a very strong advocate of how science should be organized in a society. I believe that he also recognized something which I mentioned earlier, that we in Kuwait, we pride ourselves, is to help each other. That's the spirit, humanitarian spirit. And that's what he embodied throughout his life. And I think I said earlier, this is what Kuwait prides itself in being open, whether it is the Syrian refugees, whether it is Sudan, whether it is in science, whether it is in the disasters. Before oil and after oil, Kuwait society was always like that. And it will remain like this. This is why I'm very happy to assist the ICTP leadership, Professor Atish in particular, in developing and establishing various modalities for supporting, including the setting up a fund. And what's important, regardless whether it is an international fund or a program or an activity, what's important is that we all get involved in it. The grassroots is much more important, in my view, than one donor. So I would urge all of the faculty, all of the alumni, all of the students, today or in the future, to make a contribution. I have a rule. 1,000 multiplied by 1,000 gives you 1 million. We have 1,000 alumni, make 1,000 euro, you get a million. And if you can do that with a matching from a big donor, that million becomes 10 millions. And that's really what I've been working with Atish and Corinne and others here to try to make this thing happen as a reality. I'm committed to support in all of your efforts to make it happen. And in conclusion, because if this happens, then I think we have kept the torch of Salam spirit shining brilliantly, as it should, always. It was uttered before me. And it's when it shines brilliantly, what does it do? It becomes a beacon for you, the students, to guide you in your endeavors, so that you become a torch for others and so on. In closing, I once again would like to thank the Salam family, the leadership of ICTP, for the honor that you have bestowed on me and my co-recipients, which I wish to congratulate them. And I wish to reiterate that I dedicate the recognition of this award to my family, to my friends, to the leadership of my country, Kuwait, and to the citizens, because when we make contribution, it is not the leadership only that makes the contribution, it's the whole country that makes that contribution, willingly. Thank you all. Keep the inspiration and the spirit of Salam alive and being always a shining, bright beacon. Thank you very much.
So thank you, Ahmed, and thank you and congratulations once more to the recipients today. It was really wonderful to hear. I mean, it's always, and you know, you have seen it yourself now. It's really wonderful to see the real impact and how ICTP has touched the scientific lives and as well as their personal lives of so many people around the world. And it's not an, it's a legacy that we all respect and honor, and it gives us, you know, additional strength to really make ICTP shine even brighter in the future. And I would like to thank the Salam family, as well as the recipients here, and also the kind words of Adnan to help us in our endeavors to, you know, go bigger. And this is the ambition that we should all have. So I also have another small, I mean, I had announced in the staff meeting that there is another surprise that is waiting for us. So I hope we will be joined shortly by Professors Monica and Kaiser Shafi from Delaware. Are they?
Hello.
Hello. Hi, hi, Kaiser. Hello, Monica.
Hi, hi. How are you?
Hello.
Welcome. As you can, I hope you can see the audience here. It's a collection of all the new students who have come here, the faculty, all the staff members, and the Salam. Okay, Ahmed is sitting in the corner, and the recipients of the Abdus Salam, Spirit of Abdus Salam Award. So I'm very happy to, it's my pleasure to introduce both of them. Kaiser and Monica Shafi are longtime friends and supporters of ICTP. So in 2022, their support through the International Science Fund, which I mentioned, allowed the creation of the Kaiser and Monica Shafi Prize. This prize will be awarded to the best diploma student of the year to recognize and encourage the next generation of young scientists. So ICTP, on behalf of ICTP, I would like to thank them both for this initiative. It's only a beginning. They, like Adnan, they are really very committed, and they are, you know, helping us to spread the word around and really reach out to a bigger and broader community of ICTP's well-wishers. So thank you very much for the initiative and commitment to ICTP and its mission. Let me say just quickly a few words about Kaiser by way of introduction. I have met him personally a number of times, and it's a pleasure to have him here on this special occasion. He's a Pakistani-American theoretical physicist and the inaugural Bartol Research Institute Professor of Physics at the University of Delaware. He studied physics at Imperial College, and that should ring a bell for you, because Salam, as you know, was at Imperial before he came here. He received his BSc honors and PhD, and his advisor was, in fact, Abdus Salam, the late Professor Abdus Salam. And he subsequently joined him at the International Center for Theoretical Physics. And from the early 1980s until 1997, he co-organized many several weeks-long summer schools at ICTP. And as you know, many of them are really very high-profile international schools in the field. Kaiser has done pioneering research in areas ranging from grand unification to Kaluza-Klein line theories and inflationary cosmology and supersymmetric theories. So welcome, Professor Shafi. I would like to now introduce you to Professor Monica Shafi. She is Elias Ahuja Professor Emerita of German Literature at the University of Delaware, where she also was the chair of the Department of Women and Gender Studies. She is the author of several books on German and Austrian literature and numerous publications on contemporary German literature. So before giving the floor to Professors Monica and Kaiser Shafi, I request the diploma coordinators who are present here to introduce themselves, just so that, you know, even though you are not able to be here in person, you will get a sense of some of the colleagues who are working on this. So we'll start with high energy physics. You know, Kaiser, this is close to your, closer to your heart, I would say. Professor Paolo Creminelli.
Hello. Paolo, I've met you. In 2019.
Nice to meet you. Actually, I'm not the coordinator of the high energy diploma, but Giovanni Villadoro cannot be here today. So, but I am currently the head of the high energy program. So, nice to see you again.
Okay, then we move to the condensed matter section and statistical physics. Misha Kiselev, professor.
Hello. I'm Mikhail Kiselev. I'm coordinator of the postgraduate program in condensed metaphysics and the whole postgraduate program unit at ICTP. So I welcome all students to ICTP, and I give a microphone to my colleague, Ricardo.
Yes, Professor Ricardo Farnetti, who is the Earth and Science, Earth System Physics section.
Yes, my name is Ricardo Farnetti, and I'm the coordinator of the Earth System Physics Diploma Program. Very nice to meet you.
Then we move to mathematics, Professor Stefano Luzzatto.
Hello, good afternoon. My name is Stefano Luzzatto. I'm also standing in for the coordinator, Professor Goetze, but I'm very pleased to have this opportunity to thank you for your kind interest. I was also for 10 years at Imperial College, actually, before coming here. And I'm also the coordinator of a very similar program to the diploma program in Lahore, Pakistan. So it's a very great pleasure to meet you.
Okay, and finally, this is our newest section in quantitative life sciences, Professor Matteo Marsili.
Hello, I'm Matteo Marsini, very pleased to meet you. I'm, the coordinator of the diploma program with these great students here. And thank you very much for your interest and support.
Okay, so now I give the floor to you, to Monica and Kaiser.
Thank you very much. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Yes. Monica, can you hear me?
I can hear you. Yes. Right. I can hear you. I'm not sure about the audience.
No, we can hear you.
Can you hear me? No, you can hear. That's good. Well, thank you very much for this opportunity, Atish. It has been a pleasure, really, to listen to the distinguished speakers and awardees of this Spirit of Salam Award, right? I mean, this center is a very special place in our hearts for Monica, too, because sort of as young students, like I see the diploma students who have just joined, we learned at ICTP how to grow up as a scientist, really, quite frankly. So I heard Ahmed Salam's speech. I don't know whether he remembers it. We heard him in 2016, right, at the 90th anniversary for Salam. That was held in Singapore. It was a scientific meeting with a lot of distinguished speakers, actually. So I have briefly, I have connections to Abdus Salam, of course, being my PhD advisor. And then after completing my training, I came to ICT for a year, actually.
And eventually it was decided that after Abdus Salam got his Nobel Prize, that I was at CERN at the time, that I'll come back to Trieste and be the staff member there. But due to family reasons, we decided to move to the US. But it is no exaggeration to state that ICTP has been a very important place for me throughout my entire career, actually. It's an institution that I feel very loyal to, like we heard from others too, and that I wish to succeed and grow in every way possible. So since some of you have just arrived at the ICTP, you should look at the history, read about it, and it's also documented in the photos on display as you enter the reception area of ICTP. I was last there about 3 years ago before COVID came. So very special place for me. And it's a place where actually I've enjoyed, that's where I met Conchetta also, in case she remembers us. And in fact, you make lifelong partnerships, friendships, in fact, when you come to ICTP. You know, I have collaborators now, especially one or two of them, with whom I've collaborated for the last almost 50 years or so. So starting in the early 80s, I was spending basically every summer at the ICTP, co-directing the summer schools in high energy physics and cosmology with Professor Abdus Salam, with Jogesh Patti, Antonio Massiero, who is at the University in Padua, and many others. One or two, alas, have passed away. But these were very good schools. We started with phenomenology, and then string theory came along, and so then it became a very extensive school, and many of the highly acclaimed theoretical physicists and string theorists actually around the globe came to ICTP to attend the summer school. That I can assure you, I can name many of them, right? We had the best speakers, and Abdus Salam philosophy was, look, these people are coming from around the globe, make sure you get the best people who know the subject and who can teach well. And that was the goal for many years, in fact. I stopped going there primarily because Professor Salam passed away. That was my intimate connection, but I've kept my connection with ICTP at some level. And so this is where I also met in the early 1990s, as we heard, the diploma program was started at ICTP. And I used to see them because Monica and I, with the young children, two young children we had, we would stay in the Adriatico, and that's where we would meet at lunch, at dinner, sometimes even for coffee breaks, you know, some of the students. So even though a couple of students, in fact, did their degree with me, PhD degree, who had done the ICTP diploma course, I've met many more, mostly in high energy physics and cosmology, but also in condensed matter physics, and some in mathematics, just because I've been to different countries and so on, and who came and introduced themselves to me. So what was special about these diploma students was not only their level of preparation, solid foundation, in-depth knowledge, but also their enthusiasm and motivation, their energy qualities that are critical, actually, for a successful career in science. So this, I think, I cannot imagine any other place, in fact, which can offer a better preparation for a PhD program in these sciences. I'm thinking of the top places, right? You can look at the graduate programs for preparing for a PhD, and I think ICTP is ranked amongst the top, if not right at the top, actually. So given my decades-long association with the ICTP, having worked at the ICTP in different roles and feeling as excited about its mission as I did when I first came there a long time ago, it was a logical step for me and Monica to endow some kind of an award, endow prize in this case for the diploma. I'm sure the administration at ICTP will tell you more about it. But discussing this venture with the current ICTP leadership, we decided it would be best to open it to all fields. That would be what Abdus Salam would have wanted, I think, not restrict oneself to any particular area. So not just restrict to high energy physics, cosmology, or condensed matter, just open it to all the fields and motivate as much as possible the students. I'm sure you guys are already well motivated. This is one of the best programs you can attend. So it's wonderful, really, to see this group of young scientists, and I wish you a most successful and enjoyable stay at the ICTP. Last but not least, I would like to acknowledge Monica, who is always
Thank you.
And my wife, Monica, who's, you know, as you heard from German literature, but has always supported this effort of mine in the summers to commit oneself for, I mean, Abdus Salam used to tell me, why can't you have a school for 3 months in the summer? Now, of course, we used to have it for several weeks, that I can tell you, 6 to 8 weeks was not so uncommon. But she has been always very supportive while we directed the schools. And with a lot of advanced planning and organization, she managed to get her own work done while we were in Trieste. So that was also important. So good luck, and I hope to see you all in person next August during the award ceremony. Thank you very much again to the ICTP administration, especially the director, Atish, the diploma director, Misha, Corinne and Sabrina from the development office, who have always been very kind to work. And I look forward to interacting with them in the future and making more, and taking more initiatives, hopefully, in the near future. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Monica, would you like to add something?
Okay, can you hear me?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Oh, wonderful. Yes, we can, yeah.
So greetings, actually, I hope the technology works. I'm on my iPhone here in New York, and it's an absolute pleasure and a great honor to be part of this gathering, of this meeting, even if it's only, I wish we could. It does bring back many, many fond, only second to what Kaiser has said about our long association with the ICTP. And as you can imagine, Kaiser and I very much work as a team. And we were delighted that we were able to create this prize, this award, and do a little bit from our part to support the mission of the ICTP, which is absolutely unique in the world, I believe, and to honor the legacy of the late Professor Abdus Salam, who has been such a role model, not just for Kaiser as a scientist, but for both of us. And I do apologize for the dog barking in the background. It's our dog, so yeah. So that's what happens if you work from home. So thank you so much for creating this event. And also I wish to extend my greetings, especially to the incoming students. I wish you a most wonderful year of intense research, friendships, collaborations, and I also hope you get to explore Trieste, which is really a unique city in Italy, and the Italian culture. So best of luck to all of you from me. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Okay, so thank you very much, all of you, for attending. I would like to again congratulate the winners of the Spirit of the Abdus Salam Prize. Thanks again to Ahmad and the Salam family, and to Adnan and the Shafi family for the support that they are giving to continuing the mission of ICTP in this manner. I think it's really very apt that they are the first to launch this new initiative of the International Science Fund of ICTP. And I really am very grateful. And I hope this is a beginning of a very important initiative which will help the mission of ICTP. So, I would like to, normally what we will do now is that we will exit this room and we will go to the terrace for light refreshments. I will leave the students here. They can interact with Professors Monica and Kaiser Shafi. You can ask them questions. And then you can join us later on the terrace. We will keep you some refreshments. So thank you very much again.